Hello, I kind of surprised you, didn't I? I am doing devotions and advertised it Monday through Thursday. It's Friday today, so this is just a bonus, and I just wanted to come on anyway, but it is Monday through, everybody, Thursday, and it's Friday today. So if you're disoriented, maybe that'll help. Well, Jesus Christ lives. He's alive and well, and so that's what our faith is all about, is following the risen Lord Jesus who died for our sins. John chapter 4, the woman at the well. Jesus and the disciples get to a very historic well, and the disciples go on to town to get food, and Jesus is at the well alone. And it says, a Samaritan woman came to draw water, and Jesus said to her, "Will you give me a drink?" His disciples had gone into town to buy food. The Samaritan woman said to him, "You're a Jew and I'm a Samaritan woman. How can you ask me for a drink? For Jews do not associate with Samaritans." And Jesus answered, "If you knew the gift of God and who it is that asks you for a drink, you would have asked him and he would have given you living waters. Sir, you have nothing to draw with and the well is deep. Where can you get this living water? Are you greater than our father Jacob?" And Jesus answered, "Everyone who drinks this water will be thirsty again, but whoever drinks the water I give him will never thirst again. Indeed, the water will become like a spring of water welling up to eternal life." And then the woman says she's going to call her father. Jesus calls her on that and says, "Well, you aren't married, but you've been married before," and kind of just told some things that only God would know. And so she was kind of drawn in. "Believe me," he says, "the time is coming when you'll not worship here or in Jerusalem, but you'll worship in spirit. I know the Messiah called Christ is coming. When he comes, he'll explain everything. I who speak to you am he." She was converted. And then it says in verse 39 of chapter 4 of John, many of the Samaritans from that town believed in him because of the woman's testimony. She said, "He told me everything I ever did." So when the Samaritans came to him, they urged him to stay with them. And he stayed 2 days. And because of his words, many more became believers. And then they said to the woman, "We no longer believe because of what you have said. Now we've heard for ourselves, and we know that this man really is the Savior of the world." He's the Savior of the world. Now, a couple things in this story. First of all, a convert was able to give testimony and bear witness to Jesus Christ, to evangelize. Many times, the way things are set up, it doesn't work that way, because we somehow think we have to learn things in our head and understand the doctrine, and then at some point we'll be able to share it with somebody else when we understand everything. You don't have to understand anything right now. The woman at the well only understood one thing, that the Messiah came, he loved her, and he was in essence calling her to follow him. And so evangelism can happen at any time, because if you know Jesus Christ. So our goal in church is to know Jesus Christ better. That's our bottom line, to get more intimate with the Lord Jesus. For so long, Lutherans and other denominations, but us Lutherans, it's been knowledge and intellectualization, not faith and spirituality. And they go hand in hand, head faith, heart, head and heart, both parts of faith. But Paul says in Galatians that the gospel came to me not from man, nor was I taught it. Okay, you're not taught the faith. You have a revelation of Jesus Christ. And then you also are taught and learn. But I was not taught the gospel. Paul experienced Jesus Christ on the road. Now, we can share Jesus Christ immediately upon conversion if it's real and genuine. It will change our lives. We get excited. It is like I said in church some weeks ago. It's like hitting the lottery. You know, we hit the lottery. And so we're looking for Samaritan women whom we can share about the Messiah, Jesus Christ, so that those people may come to a saving knowledge of Christ. And we encourage faith to grow and go beyond what it is now in our lives through our daily life, through our seeking God in prayer, worshiping him outside of Sunday and in Sunday. And so our goal is to have people that are excited. We have a terrible location for a church and a little sign that I know there's limitations on what size of signs and all that. It doesn't matter if things go the right way. You see, what's going to draw people to a church is that men and women are excited about Jesus Christ. They committed, they're all in Jesus Christ, that they show that in their storms they have peace, if they show love for those who are sinners. It's the excitement that we're looking for, that only the Holy Spirit can give. But as we experience God in our life, answering prayer, giving us gifts, guiding and directing us, we become even more excited about knowing this living Lord Jesus Christ. That's what we're talking about. Now, what we can do about this is get more into the Word of God. Get into the Word. Get into prayer more. Not legalistically. God doesn't love you anymore. He can't love you anymore by you doing things. But just anyway, we want to get excited about knowing Jesus. Heavenly Father, we thank you that Jesus lives and that he lives for us. Help us, Father, become excited about what you have and what you've given and the love you have for us. May we know it so deeply that it just changes us, in Jesus' name. Amen. Well, let's worship Jesus today, but also let's make Jesus known, and also let's just lift him up, make him the center of our lives, in Jesus' name. Ciao.